Hello and welcome back to Scale Me Down and to part 4 of this VQ Models Twin Otter that we've put on floats. Please remember to like and subscribe to support the channel. And it's test flying day. Today we're going to conduct a range check now she's up on her floats, and then initially we're going to try her off the grass. Let's see how she performs.
I started with a thorough range check from 30 paces. She needed a bit of help getting going, as the grass was quite dry and therefore a bit grippy. However, once airborne and trimmed, she flew well. I went on to test the stall, which apart from the additional drag, was unaffected by the floats. But then disaster struck when one of the propellers fell off. Let's take a closer look at that. By throttling back a little and lowering the nose, I wrestled it back to the landing strip. I got it down, but I busted the floats a bit. When I got them back to the workshop, most of the damage was inside the floats. So I cut some neat holes and then spliced the broken bits with some lolly sticks and epoxy. Then, after some sanding, glassing, priming, etc., we were ready to try again.
So here we are on a perfect day and all the repairs are done. And I think I've solved the problem, as now the propellers are fitted with nylock nuts, so they shouldn't come undone again. Sadly, most of the damage was internal on the floats, as you saw, so we had to cut holes in them all. But it's all put back together now. We'll try it on the water surface and hopefully this time be less exciting.
As the water surface is calm and glassy, we'll taxi out and make some ripples to help it unstick a little better. Also checking to avoid the local air traffic. We'll just get her trimmed out. Did you see that? Let's take a closer look. The number 2 motor shut down for some reason. At the time, I thought it was a glitch with the radio gear, but I thought it'd be prudent to land anyway. Safely down, and I checked to see that the propellers were still tight, which they were, so I decided it must be the radio gear, and I resighted the receiver aerials and conducted another range check before trying again. The switchable water rudders and reverse thrust are really useful features for retrieving the model. Meant that we didn't need our rescue boat, HMS Most Leaky, on this occasion. We got some really nice flights with her. We did get one or two other glitches during the day. Thank you. sure if the glitches are caused by the radio receiver aerials being blanked, or whether it's just the speed controllers going into auto current or auto temperature shutdown, or perhaps it's those capacitors we put on the speed controller power leads. But in any case, we had a brilliant day and she was really fun to fly. It was really nice to see this de Havilland twin otter in her natural element.
That's a bit better. There's still a few teething troubles to sort out, particularly with the radio signal, but we'll sort that next time. Hope you enjoyed that. I certainly did. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.